You know, there are two hidden reasons behind your thyroid issues like hypothyroidism and Hashimoto's, which most doctors overlook and don't test for. If all your thyroid labs are coming out normal, but you're still struggling with all sorts of low thyroid symptoms, this could possibly be why. And that's estrogen dominance and progesterone deficiency. Many women who struggle with thyroid issues actually have either high estrogen or low progesterone or both. Let's demystify these hormones in this video. In order to understand how these hormonal imbalances cause your thyroid problems, you need to first understand what estrogen dominance is and how these hormones are playing in your body. So estrogen is a hormone that is dominant in your first half of your menstrual cycle, which is called the follicular phase, and progesterone is the hormone which is dominant in the second half of your menstrual cycle, called the luteal phase. Now, imagine it like a seesaw. Your estrogen and progesterone have to strike a balance in every cycle to kind of counteract the effects of each other so that your cycles are optimal. Now, in estrogen dominance, what happens is your estrogen is higher relative to your progesterone. Now, this doesn't mean always that your estrogen levels are high. Yes, your estrogen hormone levels could be higher than normal. That also causes estrogen dominance. But your estrogen levels can be absolutely normal, but you have low progesterone. So relative to your progesterone, your estrogen is actually higher, which is also estrogen dominance. Estrogen dominance can manifest itself as a lot of symptoms in your body, like irregular periods, painful periods, heavy periods, infertility, PCOS, endometriosis, mood swings, and a lot of PMS, and even breast cancer. So how does this estrogen dominance cause thyroid issues? Let's explore. Estrogen dominance can cause your liver to produce high levels of this protein called TBG, which is thyroid binding globulin. This TBG can attach itself to the free thyroid hormones that are circulating in your bloodstream. So your free thyroid hormones are there in your bloodstream, and then they are fed to your cells, which can use that up to increase your metabolism and fuel up various activities in your body. Now, when it binds to this free thyroid hormone, obviously your active thyroid hormone levels available to circulate in the bloodstream decreases a lot. Now, when this decreases, your cells are starving of the thyroid hormone. They're not getting enough, which can manifest itself as symptoms of low thyroid or hypothyroidism. Now, this doesn't actually show up in your blood test. So your labs might keep coming back as normal. Your TSH, T4, T3, all of the levels could be coming back as normal, yet you have hypothyroidism at a cellular level, which leads to symptoms like fatigue, weight gain, hair loss, feeling cold all the time, and sluggish metabolism, and all sorts of symptoms. Now, let's look at the second reason, which is the progesterone hormone. So, like I mentioned, this is the hormone that is more dominant in your second half of your menstrual cycle, called the luteal phase. Whenever you ovulate, your body starts producing progesterone. Now, you need to ovulate in order for your body to produce enough progesterone. So if you don't ovulate, there is no progesterone. So when you ovulate and your body produces enough progesterone, this actually increases the activity of an enzyme called TPO in your thyroid, which is the thyroperoxidase enzyme, which actually helps in making more of the thyroid hormones T4 and T3. So your body produces more T4 and more T3. This in turn will increase your body temperature and also regulate your metabolism. This is exactly the reason why when you ovulate, your temperature slightly rises. So you can actually track your basal body temperature, and you can see that before ovulation it is lower, and after ovulation there is a slight increase. And this is actually one of the effective ways to actually see if you are successfully ovulating in every cycle. Now, I digress, but coming back to it, let's look at what happens when you have low progesterone or progesterone deficiency. Now, suppose, let's say you're not ovulating for whatever reasons, you know, there is stress and there's a lot of deficiencies, or there is like a lot of other root causes, inflammation, etc., going on in your body, and you don't ovulate in every cycle. So if you don't ovulate, there is no progesterone, which means there is a reduced activity of this enzyme called TPO, which in turn causes a reduction in the reduction in the amount of thyroid hormones T4 and T3. So your cells are not getting enough of these thyroid hormones. This results in low thyroid symptoms, leading to hypothyroidism. Now, this again may not show up on your labs initially. That is why you have to really go by your symptoms. Your symptoms are your body's way of talking to you and telling you that something is wrong. So even if your doctor is saying that your labs are absolutely normal, but you know you're not feeling good in the body, you know something is wrong, you have to investigate. And this is something you should dive into, which is checking your hormone levels, your estrogen and progesterone, very specifically to check if you are ovulating, if you have enough progesterone, and if you have more estrogen, or in relative to progesterone, you have a estrogen dominance. So these actually are the two main hidden triggers of thyroid issues. Now, your estrogen dominance, of course, it has an impact on your thyroid hormones, which we looked at, but it also has an impact on your immune function, which is one of the reasons why if you have estrogen dominance, it can increase your thyroid antibodies like TPO and TG, which is thyroglobulin, and it can be a trigger for developing autoimmune thyroid conditions like Hashimoto's. So if you are struggling with symptoms like fatigue, hair loss, weight gain, low libido, sluggish metabolism, brain fog, mood swings, constipation, high cholesterol, feeling cold all the time, brittle nails, these are all the classic symptoms of hypothyroidism, which you should not ignore. Even symptoms like PCOS, endometriosis, any kind of menstrual irregularities or issues can indicate that there is something going on with your thyroid, and you need to dig deeper to address these root causes. Now, I teach you in one of my online courses called Master Your Menstrual Cycle, I teach you how to actually work on your hormone balance, how to work on getting your estrogen and progesterone levels in balance through this powerful method called cycle syncing. So you will learn how to actually change your diet, your exercise, your lifestyle, your work, all your day-to-day activities to align with the different phases of your menstrual cycle, so that you can support the right hormones in every phase. So in follicular phase, you can ensure that you don't have high estrogen, so you eat the right type of foods, you fuel your body with the right type of vitamins and minerals to ensure that you reduce that excess estrogen. And in the luteal phase, you eat the kind of foods and fuel your body with the nutrients to boost the progesterone production. So if you are interested in getting more information about it, I'm including the link to it in the description below. And if you found this video to be helpful, do spread the love, like the video, and share it with someone who is struggling with these symptoms and who needs to know this information. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for weekly videos on functional medicine and nutrition. I'll see you soon in my next video.